With the conclusion of the 2023 Dubai Airshow, it's time to tally up the orders and answer the all-important question: Airbus or Boeing? While Boeing may have scooped up nearly three times as many orders as Airbus, at 295 to 86 respectively, the answer may not be as straightforward as it seems. For today's video, let's examine how the world's two major aircraft manufacturers stacked up against each other. The event appears to have been a turning point for US aircraft manufacturer Boeing. Following the grounding of its 737 MAX program, issues with its 787 Dreamliner production, and supply chain issues, it seemed as if airlines had begun to lose their confidence in Boeing for a short period. However, the Dubai Airshow saw numerous airlines voice their confidence in Boeing's ability to deliver. Europe's Airbus hasn't been without its issues. Its A320neo and A220 family aircraft have proven popular. Indeed, in 2019, the A320 officially overtook the 737 in terms of orders, despite entering the market 20 years after Boeing's narrowbody. However, supply chain problems and production delays have limited delivery slots for the A320neo until 2029, a major setback for any operator hoping to boost their short-term capacity. What's more, Airbus's production delays and Pratt & Whitney GTF groundings are having a clear impact on the fleet of many airlines. This may have been another contributing factor in terms of low popularity at the Dubai Airshow. Indeed, not a single A320neo family aircraft, including its usually industry-beloved A321XLR, was ordered at the event. Boeing received a much-needed narrow-body order from Ethiopian Airlines with a commitment for 21 737 MAX aircraft. The Addis Ababa-based airline was notably the face of the 737 MAX grounding following the crash of Flight 302 in March 2019. Speaking to Bloomberg, CEO Mesfin Tasso reaffirmed his confidence in Boeing and the 737 MAX program, noting that the airline had done its due diligence to ensure Boeing had corrected the issue with the Maneuvering Characteristics Augmentation System, or MCAS, cited as the cause behind the crashes of Ethiopian Airlines Flight 302 and Lion Air Flight 610. "We believe we have checked and confirmed that the design defect of that aircraft has been fully corrected by Boeing. We have renewed our confidence in that aircraft," he stated. The order came as a significant snub to Airbus, with Tasso claiming that it had expressed interest in Airbus's A220 aircraft to replace its turboprop fleet. However, it would not consider placing an order until issues with its Pratt & Whitney PW1500G turbofan engines were resolved. Not all airlines appear to feel the same way towards the A220. Indeed, Latvian flag carrier Air Baltic scooped up an additional 30 A220-300s, plus 20 more options. The updated order will see the airline become the largest A220 operator in Europe, with 100 aircraft set to pad out its fleet by 2030. CEO Martin Gauss offered an alternative view to the one held by Ethiopian Airlines, saying, "Let us say the engine is maturing, and we wouldn't have placed an order if we didn't have full trust in the aircraft with the engine." Other 737 MAX customers include Turkish-German leisure carrier Sun Express, which placed a firm order for 28 MAX 8s and 17 MAX 10s, as well as options for up to 45 more. Kazakh carrier SCAT Airlines also made a commitment for 7 MAX 8s. Though not a direct order, the 737 MAX also saw a significant boost from Egypt Air, which signed a 12-year lease with Lesser Air Lease Corporation, or ALC, for 18 of the type. Egypt Air will take delivery of the aircraft between 2025 and 2026, operating them alongside its existing A320neo aircraft. When it comes to the higher-capacity jets, the yet-to-launch 777X was undoubtedly the star of the Dubai Airshow, with Emirates ordering 90 more aircraft. This brings its current order for the type to 205. Emirates currently expects to take delivery of its first 777X in 2025, according to Boeing's current production targets. Emirates' deal with Boeing also included a unique maintenance, repair and overhaul, or MRO, contract that will allow the US aircraft manufacturer to provide augmented and virtual reality capable drones for Emirates' 777 maintenance program. In a statement shared by the airline, Emirates explained the decision behind the add-on MRO partnership, saying, "These technologies promise to deliver more precise and comprehensive aircraft inspections, reduce the risk of human error, and significantly cut down the time aircraft spend out of service, optimizing fleet availability and performance." Delivery of the 777X will not impact A380 operations, however. Even though the quad jet is now out of production, Emirates was clear that it had no plans to retire its A380 fleet before the 2030s, with hints that operations could go into the 2040s. The Super Jumbo may have struggled to find its place in other airlines' fleets, but Emirates has embraced the double-decker's unbeatable comfort and ability to transport over 600 passengers to its hub at Dubai International Airport. On November 15th, Airbus announced that it had signed over $1.5 billion in MRO contracts to ensure its A380 fleet remains reliable and operational through its extended life. Contracts included Pratt & Whitney, Lufthansa Technik, Collins Aerospace, and Safran, which comprised a $1.2 million seating overhaul across much of its wide-body fleet. A further 60 A380s will be retrofitted with Airbus's Airspace Link HBC Plus satellite connectivity solution during overhaul. Following some production setbacks, the aura around Boeing's 787 Dreamliner program has seemed slightly off, but that's not deterring operators. Emirates' sister airline Fly Dubai is set to officially shirk off its title as a narrowbody-only operator, ordering 30 787-9 aircraft in an $11 billion deal. Smaller orders filtered in as well. 15 airframes were ordered by Ethiopian Airlines, Royal Jordanian took 6, and Royal Air Maroc committed to 2. Emirates also adjusted its existing order, adding 5 to its current backlog for a total of 35 aircraft. Interestingly, the airline will now operate a mix of Dash 8s and Dash 10s instead of its earlier commitment for all Dash 9 variants. Like the A320neo, Airbus failed to acquire any orders for its A330neo program. Despite the previous generation becoming one of the most popular wide-body aircraft of its era, Airbus has struggled to compete against Boeing's 787 in the slightly larger middle-of-the-market segment. It was a different story for the A350. Airbus managed to bulk up its A350-900 backlog, signing deals with Egypt Air for 10, Ethiopian Airlines for 11, and Emirates for 15. Airbus initially hoped for a more significant order, likely including the A350-1000s. However, reliability issues with its Rolls-Royce XWB-97 engine appear to be putting off potential purchases, at least according to Sir Tim Clark, the president of Emirates. Emirates quietly announced its last-minute order on Thursday after several days of negotiations, choosing not to hold a signing ceremony. The decision may have been in response to Tim Clark's prior comments regarding the XWB-97's poor fit for the airline's operations. Clark noted that Emirates would perhaps consider the aircraft if alterations were made, explaining to journalists, "If the engine did what we wanted it to do, and Rolls-Royce knows what we want it to do, and so does Airbus, then we would re-enter the Airbus A350-1000 into the assessment for our fleet." Who do you think won the Dubai Airshow? Let us know in the comments. Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.